गुड आफ्टरनून वन एंड ऑल, माय नेम इज़ द डॉक्टर बी श्रीनिवास, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द सेकेंड यूनिट ऑफ ए थर्मल एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ ए मेटल कटिंग, टूल लाइफ, टूल वेयर, मशीनेबिलिटी, इकोनॉमिक्स ऑफ मशीनिंग। हियर नाउ सी हियर फ्रॉम द सेकेंड यूनिट ऑफ ए टूल वेयर, टूल लाइफ एंड मशीनेबिलिटी। इफ आई एम स्पीकिंग अबाउट द टूल लाइफ, सो वॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ टूल लाइफ? वेन ए मीन्स when a machining operation can be taken place between the workpiece and the tool. So what happens, there is a tool wear place of a very important according to the tool life. That is the reason we are saying that is a machinability we are saying. Okay. Now coming to the what is a tool life. The tool life can be defined as a time interval for which the tool works satisfactory between two successive of a grinding and sharpening. The tool is subjected to a wear continuously, means here the tool is subjected to a wear continuously when the machining operation is taken place. Here the tool wear is increased considerably and the tool loses its ability to cut the efficiency here and must be regrounded. If not, it will be a totally fails here. Okay. Example, there is a three ways of a expressing of a tool life. The first point is a expressing of a tool life is the useful of a cutting life of a tool expressed in terms of a time period measured from start to cut to failure of the tool, and time period between two consecutive of a resharpening and the replacement. Means here the useful of a cutting life of the tool expressed in a time means here as a time period is in minute between the two successive of a grinding, we can also say. So in terms of a number of component machined between two successive of a grinding, the second point here. And third one is a time period between the two consecutive of a resharpening or replacement, that is a due to of a in terms of a volume of a material removed from the between of a two successive of a grinding. And this is more is expressed as a commonly used, we can also say. Okay, this is the tool life here. Now coming to the in which way it can be a measure, in which way we are saying means number of workpiece of the work can be machined, number of a workpiece of the work can be machined here, total volume of a material is removed from the workpiece here, total length of the cut of the workpiece, and the limiting value of a surface finishing here, and even the increasing in a cutting forces, means when a tool is in contact with the workpiece, how is the increase in a cutting forces here, and that is the F and N, and here the dimensionally accuracy here, and overheating, there is a means again the heating, there is a due to the temperature here, and the rupture can be taken place here, fuming we can also say, and the presence of catter here. Means in this way we are saying of a we are studying about the means is all that is a total is related with a workpiece, and this is a ways of measuring of a tool life here. Means how much the workpiece can be removed here, what are the volume, what are the length of the workpiece, can be a depth and the what can be a cut can be taken place here, this everything can be taken place of a workpiece, that can be measure of the tool life here. The modes of a tool failure means just now I said the temperature failure, means here the modes of a tool failure is due to the when a machining operation is taken place between the tool and the workpiece here. Due to this one, what happened? Temperature failure and the rupture of the tool point here and the gradual wear at the tool point here. Means this is due to of a temperature failure. Just now we know that if a huge of a pressure and the temperature is taken place, automatically at the cutting edge, what happened? Buildup edge will be formed here. So here due to the plastic deformation of a cutting edge due to the high temperature here, cracking at of a cutting edge due to a thermal stresses, and even with the rupture of the tool point, we are knowing that a chipping of a tool edge due to a mechanical impact and crumbling of a cutting edge due to of a buildup edge here. So due to the pressure and the temperature of the means where this property of a this of a work material is stick with the tool. So this is a due to the temperature failure, it will also comes in a rupture of the tool point here and gradually wear at the tool point. That is a flank wear and catter wear. Flank wear we can say also that is a end point, and we can say catter is a face point also we can say here. Okay, coming class we discuss about this one. And the tool wear is a causes the tool to lose its original shape ineffectively of a cutting speed here. And tool needs to be a resharpening. Here we are saying of a tool wear means here after the tool life, the tool wear is cause the tool to lose its original shape. Due to the what happened, there is a continuous using the tool life, due to that one tool wear can be taken. So what happened, there will be having a wearing can be taken place here. Okay. So this is due to the how it can be taken. Means that is depend upon the factor affecting of a tool life, we can also say. Okay. Means here we can say the tool life is a tool wear can be depends upon the factor affecting of a tool life also we can say here. Due to this one, what happened, this is an original, it will lose its shape. And immediately we have to be tool need to be a resharping or re-grinding also we can say here. Now coming to the cause of a tool wear, attrition wear, diffusion wear, abrasive wear, electrochemical wear, chemical wear, plastic deformation, thermal cracking. These are the cause of a tool wear here. Means now coming to the step by step. So attrition wear is a low cutting speed, fragment of a tool are torn off from the tool surface of a intermediate and a high. So now coming to the what happened, due to we know that if a cutting speed is very high, automatically remove the work, material from the workpiece. If a low speed, what happened, attrition wear will be taken place at the tool here. That is the flow of material past of a cutting edge is irregular and less stream of a line can be. That is the reason the build up edge, if a low cutting speed is taken place, build up edge is formed and a discontinuous of a contact with the tool here due to the low cutting speed. In the same manner, what happened, fragment of a tool also can be taken place. Okay, means there will be a torn of a, means removing of a torn of a tool surface also we can say. And a high means slow and interrupted of a cutting and the presence of a vibration found in a carbide tool at a low cutting speed here. Even with the high, what happened, there is a vibration will occur. That is also when a vibration is a machining operation take place, when a tool is in contact with the workpiece here, there is a vibration will be occurred here on the tool. Due to that also, there is the attrition wear can be found here. And diffusion means there will be a property of a material of a workpiece can be in contact with the tool. The diffusion of a metals and the carbon atoms from the tool and surface into the workpiece and the chip here. And due to this, due to the high temperature and the pressure, we know that the rapid flow of a chip and the workpiece past the tool, that is the reason build-up edge will be formed here. So that is the reason there will be a tool life will be a gets of a tool wear can be take place here. Diffusion rate of a depend on the metallurgical relation and significant in a carbide tool here. In the same manner, abrasive wear due to the presence of a hard material in the workpiece of a material and the strain hardening induced in the chip, workpiece of a due to the plastic deformation and contribution to a flank wear, and the effective can be reduced by the fine grain size of the tool and the lower percent of a cobalt. Means abrasive wear is also a presence of a hard material. When I am using of a hard of a ductile of a material, so what happened, there is a, it will take off a more strain can be taken place. That is the reason abrasive wear of the tool can be occurred here. That is the reason the flank of a wear means is a point edge can be, it is a contribution of a main, especially at the point edge can be affected here, cutting or the point edge can be affected here. Okay, that is the electrochemical way. Just electrochemical is a mainly depend upon the ionizing of a work material and the tool material here. When ions are passed between the tool and the workpiece, oxidization of a tool surface, breakdown of a tool material into a chip into a tool interface can be taken place here. The chemical wear interaction between the tool and the workpiece and the plastic with the carbide tool and the cutting fluids here. That is the, especially with the chemical of a composition can be taken place here, there will be a wear, tool wear can be affected here. Plastic deformation, when a high of a compressive of a stress act on the tool, means especially of a, that is the reason we are saying the rake angle, we are the larger rake angle we are using here. So it, especially it is affected on the tool rake face angle and reduce of a nothing but a, in a end relief angle it will be reduces here. That is the modify of a tool geometry extract of a other of a wear process here. Thermal cracking, due to the cyclic of a thermal stresses at a cutting edge, comb cracks, transfer cracks, chipping of a tool can be taken place here. The different types of a crackers can be taken place here on the this one. And the geometric of a tool wear, just now I said of a flank wear and the cutter wear here. Flank wear is the edge wear, or we can say that is a point wear also we can say. and the caterwear wear, that is a face wear, yes, okay. Flank wear means the tool slide over the surface of the workpiece and the friction is developed. Means here the flank wear especially is caused due to the friction and the abrasion. That is the reason with the abrasion, what adhesion between the workpiece and the tool of a build-up edge. When a friction is taken place, automatically what happens, that the property of a work material is stick with the tool. That is the reason the build-up edge, and due to that one friction between can be taken place here. So especially this is a independent of a cutting condition and the tool and the work piece and the brittle and the discontinuous of a chips increase as the speed has increased here. See from the diagram of the primary stage, secondary stage and the tertiary. If I am saying of a primary stage, what happened here, the rapid wear due to a high, very high stress at a tool point, and wear rate is a more or less linear in the secondary stage. Means primary very high stress and the secondary is a more or less linear, and the third means it will be a goes into a fracture way. That is a catastrophic failure can also we can say. Now coming to the cutter wear, just now I said that the face edge, okay. See here from the face wear, okay. So from the cutter wear is a direct contact of a tool and the workpiece. That is a face wear can of a tool can be taken place here. That is the reason it will forms of a cavity, ductile of a material, of a continuous of a chip, initiated of a rapid rupture near to the nose, leads to a weakening of the tool, increasing in a cutting temperature, cutting force and the friction here. The very important point here is before going to the measurement of a tool life, first we have to know what is the factor affecting of a tool life. So factor affecting of a tool life is a cutting speed, tool geometry, work material, rigidity of a machine tool and the feed, depth of cut, tool material, nature of a cutting and the use of cutting fluid. These all are factor affecting of a tool. That is the reason we are going for the measurement of a tool life here. So here that is the reason we are going for the machinability also we can see here. So according to the factor affecting of a tool life, the measurement of a tool life can be occurred here. See here from the diagram is a cutting speed and the tool life here. That is the ASS, that is a high speed steel of a cementite or carbide oxide, ceramic and the oxide and the hypocritical. So the time for total destruction in case of high speed steel or a time to produce is a 0.75 mm of a wear of a carbide tools here. Means there is a very important point here, where tool life can be expressed in a Taylor's equation. That is a Vt to the power of B is equal to C. The V is a cutting speed and the cm per minute and the cubic per meter per minute, and the T is a total life in a minute. B is a constant, which is a ranges from a 0.1 to a for a high speed steel, and C is a 50, okay, and that's also constant for a high speed steel, cemented carbide here. So your tool life is expressed in a volume of a metal removed, that is a L is equal to V TV F into D. So these are the measurement of a tool life here. How it can be a measure by using of a different types of a technique of a we can measure of a tool life, that is a diamond indentor, radio active indentor, test at a evaluator, cutting speed facing test with a low wear of a criteria. These are the we can go with the measurement of a tool life here. Now the cutting, just now I said of a what are the factor affecting of a tool life, just now the same thing. The factor affecting of a tool life is the cutting speed, physical property of a work material here, and the area of a cut and the ratio of a feed and the depth of cut, shape and the angles of a tool material and its heat treatment, and the nature and the quantity of a coolant and rigidity of a tool and the workpiece here. Machinability, now very important point here is a machinability. The machinability according to here we are saying of it is a defined as a term of a surface finish and the surface integrity of a tool life, and the force and the power required, the level of a difficulty in a chip control. Good machinability indicates of a good surface finishing, and means here what happened here, the machinability is a material gives an idea. Means here materials gives an idea of a easy with which it can be a machine. Means that is depend upon their parameters we can also say. If I am saying of a parameters or if I am seeing are here, what is the physical property of the material here, mechanical property of the material here, chemical composition of the material here, microstructure of the material here, cutting conditions here, that all comes in a machinability here. Means that is the reason we are going for the level of a difficulty in a chip control. Means good machinability indicates a good surface finishing, surface integrating and long tool life, low surface force and the power requirement, That is the reason the property of machinability of a material depends upon a various variable factors. It is not possible to evaluate the same in terms of a precious of a nomical of a values. We can say that is the tool life, surface finishing, power consumption, and cutting force, and cutting shear angle, and rate of a metal removal. This all comes in a this one are available for the each of a material and its condition. That is the reason the factor affecting of a machinability of a metals means material of a workpiece of a sharp hardness, tensile properties, strain hardening, tool material size and the shape of the tool, type of a machining operation, size, shape of a velocity of a cut, type and the quality of a machine used, quality of a lubricant used in a machining, friction between the chip and the means the tool, workpiece of a chip and the tool, sharing of a strength of the workpiece here, material here, these are the, and in which way we are going, what are the factor affecting, what is the evaluation and what are the relatively. So here if I saying of a, see here, evaluation of a the factor affecting, after the factor affecting what happened, there will be evaluation of a machining of a factor. Means here that is the depend upon the here the tool life, form and the size of the chip, shear angle and cutting force, power consumption, surface finishing, cutting temperature, metal removal rate per tool grain, the rate of a cutting under a standard force, dimensional accuracy here. So these are the another thing is a evaluation of a machinability, means that is also from the machinability of a decreasing with a increase in a tensile strength, hardness, machinability of a material is assigned by any of the following, means it may be a tool life, limiting of a metal removal rate and a cutting force, surface finishing, chip shape. So these are the relatives of a magnesium alloy and a bearing bronze and a aluminium alloys, zinc alloys. So this all are related to the tool material. The main character of a, if I'm, this is all things means it evaluation, relatively, factor affecting of a machine, that's everything is a deals with your of a tool material. Means here the main character of a tool means good cutting of a tools material are its hot hardening, wear resistance, impact resistant we can also say, and abrasive resistance also we can say. Okay, heat conductivity and strength, that is the everything of a machinability that is depend upon the tool material. Okay, that is the reason the important of it, that is the reason very important of a tool life is a likely change in this of a characters at high temperature because of a metal cutting of a process is always associated with a generation of a high amount of heat and the high temperature. This is the reason the cutting speed has a maximum effect. Cutting speed has a maximum effect on the tool life and followed by the feed and the depth of cut. Please keep in mind that the cutting speed has a maximum effect on the tool life followed by the feed and the depth of cut of the from the workpiece, which is rise the temperature here. It always said that the ideal of a tool material is the one which removes the largest volume of the work material at all speed. It is not possible to get a truly idea of a tool of a material. The tool material which can be withstand of a maximum cutting temperature with a losing its principal material properties of especially generally we can say ensure there is a maximum tool life here. Okay, higher hot hardness, toughness in a tool life of a material is a longer the tool life here. Okay, that is the reason we are using of a different types of a tool materials like a high speed steel, high carbon steel, coated of a high speed steel, cemented carbide, stellite, diamond, cemented oxide, ceramic. These are different types. That is only the depends upon the your relative of a machinability. Okay, now the effect of a, see here the reason according to the machinability of a index we are saying. Okay, the machinability of a index having a formula of a Vt by Vs is equal to 100. Vt is the cutting speed of a metal here, 1 minute of a tool life here. Vs is equal to cutting speed of the standard of a free cutting of for 1 minute. That is the reason according to the material there will be having a machinability of a index of a values are there. Stainless steel 25, low carbon 55 to 65, these are the machinability of a index we can say. That is the machinability of index can be depend upon the ferrous materials and the on a non-ferrous. If I am saying of a ferrous of a material, that is a steels, and non-ferrous of a means that is the effect of a various elements of a steels, stainless steels. So that is the machinability of a ferrous and the non-ferrous of a materials. Okay, the non-ferrous of a materials are aluminium, beryllium, cobalt, copper, magnesium, titanium and tungsten here. Now coming to the very important point, the what is the cutting fluids means that is a very important point here, the cutting speed. So here we are saying of a cutting fluids is a decreasing the power requirement. We know when there will be having a see here when we are going for the machining operation can be taken place here. When a tool is in contact with the workpiece here, so what happened? There will be a decreasing of power requirement, increase in the heat dispersion, increase can be taken, and the neat oils plus extreme pressure additive and the water immersion. So this can be reduced, means due to the coolant, lubricant. So if I am saying of a coolant, cutting fluid used to cool the tool and the workpieces, that is called as a coolant. Means there is a machining operation taken place between the tool and the workpiece. What happened? Cutting fluid is used to cool the tool and the workpiece is called coolant. Especially for the, we are going for the CNC of a machining, 90% of a machining operation we are using of a coolant here. Water based of the fluids are most effective for the cooling the tool and the workpiece due to the higher specific of heat and the thermal conductivity. That is the coolant we are saying. Now coming to the lubricant, is a cutting fluid used for the purpose for a dimensional of a friction between the contacting of a surface of a cutting zone. That is shear zone also we are saying is called as a cutting, is called as a lubricant we are saying. Okay. And there is a especially for the types of a cutting fluid. If I am saying about the cutting type of cutting, I mean it may be a soluble oil, it may be a state oil, it may be chemical additive oil, it may be chemical compound, or it may be a solid lubricants. Okay. So that is the type of lubricant. If I say that is a liquid base, that is an animal oil, vegetable oil, mineral oil, synthetic oils, semi-solid of a lubricants. So this all are depends upon the cutting fluids here. Okay. So that is the reason that is when a machining operation take place, the cutting fluids take place a very important role. Okay. It is a cutting fluids or a lubricant. Thank you and have a nice day.